Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. Today's game is between the DePaul Blue Demons and the Texas Tech Red Raiders.
Here are a couple of the go-to guys for each team, Bill.
And our starting lineup.
No matter the game, your starting five must be ready to play. As soon as the ball is tossed up, you gotta be ready. Too many teams fall behind early because they are just not ready to perform.
And here's what the plan of attack is for either team in regards to tempo. The Blue Demons get possession and away we go. In the post. Fires. No.
Get out and fill.
The Red Raiders running their zone offense.
Now this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
Turns it over. Jacobs receives the ball. He takes the three.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
The Red Raiders set up into their four around one offense.
If you have a good postman, it's very tough to defend. Everything centers on him.
On the left side. Jump shot.
Perfect.
Made this long-range shot look easy.
Now, Gus, check out the release and rotation. What a beautiful shot.
The Red Raiders and now getting set up for around one.
If you don't help out, they just kill you.
Looking for a good shot. Shots up. He missed it.
Give me that.
Way out on the right wing. He rejects it. The Red Raiders now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
And what they do is put it on the deck, creating a pinch, and then find the open guy.
Thanks for joining us here on CBS Sports. Gus Johnson along with Bill Raftery. Shots off. And he follows it up again. He can't get it to go. Out on the right wing. Here's the pick. Heat check time from long range. Comes up empty from deep. On the right side. The Red Raiders set up four around one.
That's tough because guys can make shots and yet they can penetrate and kick.
On the right side, in the lane. And he can't get them out. Cleans the glass. Now they work it around the perimeter. Shots up. Work it around the perimeter. Turns it over. Looking for a good shot. It's a call for the foul. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
And here's a look at the first-year player.
Gus, a first-year player just getting his college career started. It's going to be a treat to watch this young man develop his game.
With the free throw.
They can set up the press.
He gets it to go. Got him trapped now, Rav.
They've got him in trouble, Gus.
The Red Raiders set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
Turns it over. On the left side. Now we've got a turnover. Now in transition. Off the mark.
They should look to push it now. A little woo-woo, Gus.
Get it down on the low block. Shots off. Takes the board. Out of bounds, and we're not going anywhere. Offensively, they'll set up from the sideline. Jump shot. No. Grabs the rebound. The Blue Demons on offense. They have four guys on the perimeter and one down low.
Great passing lanes to the big fella.
Turnover. They'll go the other way. The Red Raiders running their zone offense.
Very effective because of the power on the glass. It opens up that opportunity for tips.
They'll start from the baseline. The Red Raiders, and they're in their motion offense, working with four around one.
Well, if you have a big guy that can find people, it really puts a lot of pressure on the D.
Jacobs receives the pass. Fires. He missed it. Pulls it in. Ramsey handles the pass. The Red Raiders now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
Takes the pass in the paint. Ah, he got it up and in. Paul handles the feed. Dials up a long-range shot. No luck from downtown. Both teams looking to get in a bit of a rhythm here. On the right side. He can't get it to go. Rips it down. On the right side. He shoots from the corner. With no luck, he gets it back.
Ooh, what a flush.
This guy is a complete player in the post.
He's got a variety of moves. Quick feet, great hands. What more do you need from a postman? Just a complete post-up player.
The Red Raiders in their four-around-one motion.
Dribble drive, the ability to understand when to put it on the deck and when to screen.
And he's fouled. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but you just gotta know when to back off.
Another great second-year player here, Bill. Underclassmen are a big key for any successful program.
Gus, he's young, but he's been through his freshman year, and he's learned a lot. This is going to be another big season for him. Let's see how he does today.
He got them both. On the right side. In the lane. Shots off. Hungry for the ball.
The Red Raiders working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
On the wing.
Put a little English on it.
He cut back door. The pass was delivered.
Gus, as a coach, you teach your players to read the defense in order to make that type of pass. What's great about it is that it ended with a basket. Good job defensively.
Way out on the right wing. Jump shot. And hits. That's charging.
A classic case of a player trying to do too much, Gus. Force the issue there.
The Red Raiders, they're looking real good out there, really working together.
They've been running their beautiful motion offense to perfection. Precise cuts, timely pass, great reads, and it's resulted in some terrific moves.
On the outside. Fired. Nice block. The Blue Demons set up into their 4-around-1 offense.
If you have a good postman, it's very tough to defend. Everything centers on him.
Shots off. The Red Raiders running their zone offense.
Now, this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
Out on the right wing. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy for this guy.
Shot rejected.
Out on the wing. He shoots from the corner.
The junior.
The Red Raiders are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post wrap.
Well, anytime you get a player on the high post, you can make plays, you put pressure on the D, and that can lead to some easy open looks.
In the post, he fires it up, and he can't get the bounce.
I own it.
Try to pack it inside. Jump shot. Off the mark. Takes the rebound. Shots off.
Rebound and run.
Entry and the block.
misses. Pulls it down. The Red Raiders are playing their style and controlling the tempo.
You know, Gus, it's all about going out there and executing. They've done a great job of taking care of tempo. How about this kid, huh?
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Got it in the low block. Now with 10 to shoot. The Red Raiders on offense. They have four guys on the perimeter and one down low.
Great passing lanes to the big fella.
Way out on the right wing. No.
Second chance opportunity, Gus. That's a great way to get some easy points.
They work it around the perimeter. And he's fouled. Too aggressive on defense here. He winds up with the foul.
You always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
Here's another solid junior build.
He's been on the collegiate scene for a couple of years now. This is the year when players start to transition into more of the leadership role and really guide the younger players on the team.
Hits two at the charity stripe. Pushes it. The Red Raiders now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
And what they do is put it on the deck, creating the pinch, and then find the open guy.
Pushes it. Fires the freshman. The Red Raiders now running the four on one.
Must be alert on that defensive end because guys get pinned and they can step out and knock down the deep one.
Jump shot.
How about that? Huh? How about that back cut, Gus? These kids can play a little bit. Terrific delivery.
Seven minutes left on the game clock. He strokes it.
Big time dagger.
The Red Raiders are controlling the pace of the game.
They're doing a terrific job at playing their game, really making a conscious effort to control the tempo and imposing their will on the opposition.
On the low block. Fires. He comes up empty. Up and in. Ha-ha! How about him taking it to the cup, Bill?
Those aggressive drives are what propels this offense. There's no reason why they shouldn't continue to do this.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He puts up the tray. Not this time. Takes the board. 6 minutes left on the game clock. On the left side. Jump shot.
How about that, Gus?
Out on the right wing. Turnover by the senior. Out on the left wing. In the lane.
Perfect.
Perfect. game clock. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the corner. He buries the three. In the lane. He missed it. And he lays it up and in. He shoots from the top of the key. He can't get it to go. And lays it in. Every roster needs a few of those type of players. A blue-collar type who's not afraid to get dirty.
He may be blue-collar, but he brings an intensity that not many guys do.
In the post. In the lane.
How about this kid, huh?
We're at the four-minute mark. Shoots from the top of the key, and he can't get the bounce. On the right side. Now with 10 to shoot. Shots off. Rakes it off the rim. Offensive pull. Off the mark. The Red Raiders set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
Too aggressive on defense here, and he winds up with the foul.
Now you always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
Charity strike.
Freebies in court.
Gets it. Both free throws go. Three minutes left on the game clock. On the outside. He looks for three.
It's how to stretch the defense, Gus. If you can make those, offensively your team becomes really difficult to guard.
The Red Raiders and now getting set up for around one.
If you don't help out, they just kill you.
On the wing.
Fires.
How about that, huh?
In the post, in the lane.
Big time dagger.
Two minutes left on the game clock. In the post, jump shot and answer. Baseline. Fires and hits. They work the perimeter. Jump shot. No.
What a coach will be happy with that effort.
He missed it.
A great defensive team will limit their opponent to one shot, Gus.
The Red Raiders now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
Out on the right wing. Can finish.
These kids can play. Just a nice feed on the back cut.
steps up. On the wing.
How about that, Gus?
Looking for a good shot.
One half is in the books. Stay tuned for CBS at the half.
And a look at our game summary will give you an idea of how these two teams are stacking up against one another so far. Here's a look at how both teams are doing with their keys to the game.
Going with the minimum.
The Red Raiders in their four-round-one motion.
Dribble drive, the ability to understand when to put it on the deck and when to screen.
Tup it inside. First team foul. Too aggressive on defense here. He winds up with the foul.
You always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
Gus, without a doubt, this will be an emotional year for him. But the key is to stay focused on the task at hand. There'll be a time to reflect at the end of the season. His team needs him to perform at his best now.
He got them both. Shots up. No. Pulls down the board. The Red Raiders working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
Way out on the right wing. Buckets. Out on the wing. He goes for three. Outside, Jay won't go.
It's all about shot selection, Gus. It's so important to take good shots, and not necessarily the shot the defense wants you to take.
On the right side. Up a long-range shot, and in. On the outside. Turnover, they'll go the other way. And it's going to be out of bounds. No! Great save! That goes out of bounds, but we'll stay at this end. The Red Raiders have been getting it done tonight as a team.
As a coach, it's great to see all five guys on the floor working together. That is impressive. That's how you win, and win consistently, Gus. When multiple people contribute, it takes the pressure off your superstar.
Out of bounds, and we're staying right here. Baseline inbound. Ball is saved. Great job. Ball's going to stay down here.
Inbounds play on the baseline.
In the lane.
Nice. The Blue Demons set up into their 4-around-1 offense.
If you have a good postman, it's very tough to defend. Everything centers on him.
And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. Now they work it around the perimeter.
I think this one's going the other way.
I think so too, Gus. Great call by the refs.
The Red Raiders on offense. They have 4 guys on the perimeter and 1 down low.
Great passing lanes to the big fella.
He may have gotten on ball.
Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, guys.
Coach, when a team shoots this well from the line, playing aggressive defense can come back to haunt you.
When a team shoots a high percentage from the line, it makes them that much harder to defend.
Gets 2 at the charity stripe. Coleman in the post. Jump shot. He can't get it to go.
What a rebound.
It's mine.
The Red Raiders running their zone offense.
Very effective because of the power on the glass. It opens up that opportunity for tips.
It's our call for the foul. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but you just gotta know when to back off.
Tough team to foul because they shoot such a good percentage from the line.
When everyone on the floor can convert from the line, it makes this team very tough, especially down the stretch. The opposition is trying to foul.
Both free throws go. On the left side. He attempts the trifecta. And
it's...
The Red Raiders are doing a great job of controlling the pace of this game.
I'll tell you, if you make the opposition play at your pace, it can really get them out of their comfort zone.
Now they work it around the perimeter. That finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. Sideline inbound. And he can't get them out. The sophomore. Got it up and in. On the outside.
Way to stick it, young fella.
great job of occupying the high post. I think that's why they were able to get that basket.
They got the ball into the most precious area on the court. You're right, Gus. The high post is an area it's just so hard to defend.
On the low block. Fires. Off the mark.
Rips down the board.
The Red Raiders running their zone offense.
This particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
Put a little English on it.
What a pass on the backdoor cut.
Get out of my way.
Out on the right wing. Heat check time from long range. And that's money from three. The Red Raiders and now getting set up for around one.
If you don't help out, they just kill you.
No. Oh, what a good rebound there, Gus. You got to secure those ones. The more rebounds you get, obviously, the better.
On the outside. In the lane. The junior. The left side. He shoots from outside, but he misses his target.
See the floor. He can get some easy fast breaks. Look at that block. Terrific.
He missed it. Pulls down the rebound. The Red Raiders are doing a terrific job of controlling the game.
Really done a great job establishing a good pace, a pace that suits their strengths as a team.
And no! Goes up high with two hands. Way out on the right wing. Jump shot. He can't get it to go. He rips it down, and he can't get the bounce.
Big time presentation at the rim. He made himself bigger by extending his arms.
Cross court. It's a call for the foul. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
Coach, it's tough when almost everyone on the floor can knock down free throws.
As a coach, you've got to love it when your team can knock it down at such a high rate.
He got them both.
Down the lane.
Finger roll. So easy for this guy. The Red Raiders, and they're in their motion offense, working with four around one.
Well, if you have a big guy that can find people, it really puts a lot of pressure on the D.
The senior. Shots off.
They've got to fill the lanes now. Get out and fill, please.
The Red Raiders now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
And what they do is put it on the deck, creating a pinch, and then find the open guy.
Looking for the bomb. Can't connect from the three-point line. He shoots from the corner. Nails it from downtown. The Red Raiders motion for around one.
Understanding what type of shot you want is essential in this offense.
on the right side. It's important that you get bench players who can contribute.
They may begin the game by sitting, but when they hit the floor, these guys are playing like starters. It's a big advantage to have fresh legs come in during the game and not have your team miss a beat on the offensive end.
In the paint. And he bangs it down. He's really dangerous off the bounce.
Boy, this kid has shown us some great ability. Just does a great job putting the ball on the deck and attacking the tin.
Now we've got a turnover. Foul on the play. A chance for a three-point play. The old-fashioned way.
With quick feet and strength.
One shot. Makes the foul shot. On the left side. Up and in. Ha ha! That was a nice play, Rad.
They got that one because they played through the high post, Gus. A great way to attack any type of defense is through the high post.
Looking for a good shot. Poor decision there. The Red Raiders in a hurry.
Look at that block. Terrific reaction.
Here they go in transition. And he lays it up and in. The Red Raiders now running the four around one.
Must be alert on that defensive end because guys get pinned and they can step out and knock down the deep one.
They've worked the perimeter. And it's knocked away. Great block. Got it in the low. Swatted away. Way out on the right wing. In the lane. Shots off. Loose ball saves it. Great play. Ball's going to stay here. Let's get another look at the layup.
You've got to make these inside ones, Gus. They're high percentage shots. They just got to be completed.
Ball coming in from the sideline. The Red Raiders on offense. They have four guys on the perimeter and one down low.
Great passing lanes to the big fella.
Shots up. Off that time.
Oh, physical play.
Looking for a good shot. It's stripped. Active hands. The Red Raiders set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
It give them the points. That's goaltending. And while we have a moment, let's take another look at our star matchup.
There are a lot of things that don't always show up in the stat sheet, Gus. These guys could have a horrible game up to this point, so long as they step up and make the big play when called upon.
Now they work it around the perimeter. In the lane. Off the mark. Snatches the board. Around 8 minutes remaining. Top of the key. Dials up a long-range shot. Comes up empty from deep.
Oh, physicality!
Out on the wing. From the corner! No luck from downtown. Kept alive, though. Offensive rebound. Tipped in.
What a great tip in. You've got to applaud that second effort.
Dump it inside. Turnover committed by the freshman. Pushing in transition. He missed it. Give it here. Out on the right wing. Fires. Shots off.
Get out and fill.
Now they work it around the perimeter.
Magnificent.
On the right side. 6 minutes left on the game clock. He can't get it to go.
Look to outlet!
Out on the left wing. In the lane. And he can't get the bounce. Try to pack it inside. Third team foul. Too aggressive on defense here, and he winds up with the foul.
Well, you always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
With the free one. The Red Raiders in their 4-round-1 motion.
Dribble drive, the ability to understand when to put it on the deck and when to screen.
Careless mistake there. Jacob receives the pass. In the lane. And he misses the shot. Off the mark with the shot. We're at the 5-minute mark. Out on the wing. Now we've got a turnover. Now on the run. They're called for the foul. Too aggressive on defense here. He winds up with the foul.
Now you always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
Everyone on the squad is solid from the free throw line. Their team free throw percentage is pretty good.
You know, it's always tough to play a team that can knock it down with consistency coming down the stretch.
Hits two at the charity stripe. The Red Raiders set up into their 4-around-1 offense.
If you have a good postman, it's very tough to defend. Everything centers on him.
Dump it inside. Turnover. He'll want that one back. Now looking to attack. And we have a change in possession here. In the lane. No! The Red Raiders have controlled the tempo here.
Gotta love the way they've come out here and really focused on their game plan. They've done a good job making sure the game is being played at their pace.
And lays it in. That's a good pass.
You know, he really sees the floor extremely well. Make sure his teammates get involved each and every trip down the floor.
On the outside. In the lane. The shot won't fall. On the right side. Can finish. He thread the needle.
Really did a great job at carrying the D with the back cut. Great feet and a great ability to finish in traffic.
3 minutes left on the game clock. In the paint.
Inside.
The Red Raiders are now getting set up. 4-around-1.
If you don't help out, they just kill you.
Jump shot. Can't put it there. Had his shot rejected. Coleman sees the ball. Ah, he got it up and in. Dump it inside. Fired. Up and in. 2 minutes left on the game clock. Jacob receives the pass. He tries the three. He makes the three. Block shot. Coleman handles the feed. Rise and fire. He gets it to fall. Well, Raph, this could go down to the wire.
You've got to love these close ones, Gus. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss. Gus, you've got to love these tight ones. So much on the line here. One wrong move is all it takes. There's no room for error.
Let's it go. He can't get the hoop to fall. The Red Raiders working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
In the paint. No! What a rebound. And we're back ready to get things going again after the timeout.
On the wing.
Jump shot. No! Rips it down. I'm pretty sure that they will continue to foul here, coach.
And why not? Their only choice.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Good strategy.
To the line. Gets it. It's good. And we're back, ready to get things going again after the timeout. The Blue Demons set up four around one.
That's tough because guys can make shots and they can penetrate and kick.
Drains it. And, of course, another foul as they try to remain close.
Not much else they can do.
Free throw shooting isn't his forte. Every now and then, we'll see a make a couple.
Just got to get into a routine. It's about routine and repetition. Good.
And we're ready. And we're back. Gus Johnson along with Bill Raftery with you here, ready to inbound after the timeout. Out on the wing. He lets it go. Can't get it to go. And he's fouled. the freebie. Makes the shot. Yet another stoppage and yet another foul.
And why not?
Opportunity now for an easy one. Sinks it.
Book it.
Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. On the left side, he puts up the tray. He misses from downtown.
Put a little English on it.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. Coach, when a team shoots this well from the line, playing aggressive defense can come back to haunt them.
When a team shoots a high percentage from the line, it makes them that much harder to defend.
Both free throws go. Out on the left wing. With the big shot. He doesn't get the hoop. Let's check in and have a look at our players of the game.
They were both great here today, Gus. Both ends of the court. I'm certain that they'll be happy with their performances.
That does it for us here today. Until next time, for Coach Raftery, I'm Gus Johnson. Thanks for watching College Basketball here on CBS Sports.